So we've got about 20 people on the line, which is awesome. Welcome, everybody. I'm so, so glad that you got here tonight. I know it's like 8 o'clock midweek. Things are crazy. People are juggling children and jobs and shifts and all kinds of things. So I massively appreciate you all being here and ready to learn some really great content with me. So as I was saying before, I'd love it if you've got pen and paper because I'm going to actually get you to do some of the exercises while we're on here. I don't really just like talking at people for an hour. I like you to be involved in this and doing things because I think that way you get far more from the experience. So my little chat bar is up. So if you want to pop in any messages, I can see those. If you've got any questions as we go, pop them in there. Or any just kind of realizations, that would be really cool to see that as well. Let me just double check what's on here. You're here too, Maria. Bottom corner, awesome. Sorry, I must keep moving from computer. That's absolutely fine. You can see me. Awesome. So I think everyone can hear me. Everyone can see me. Everybody is sorted, so let's go. So what I want to really share with you tonight are the 7 secrets to, I've got to like read this because I can't remember because I changed the title so many times, the 7 secrets to creating a magic mindset and how they can transform your success as an entrepreneur. Now, before I even jump into that at all, I want to put this out there, and if you listen to my videos regularly, you'll know this anyway, but I think it's really important. Everyone's version of success is totally different. When I use the word success, I am not talking about one version of success which equals this. When I'm talking about success, I mean whatever success is for you. And I think ultimately success is that thing that we strive towards creating that will make us happy, make us feel fulfilled, make us feel joyful, make us feel like we've got there. While I say that, it's equally always about the journey, about how you feel right now, about being present, about actually appreciating and feeling gratitude for where you are right now today, while you're still moving forwards towards that picture of success. So I kind of wanted to put it out there because I think it's super important that no one's kind of feeling, oh, well, like what is success? So what might be interesting is the word success triggers some people. If it triggers you, what I'd like you to do just very briefly in front of you on your paper is actually write down what does success mean to you. Like when I talk about success or when you think about success, what is its meaning? So what would, if you were living a successful life, how would that look? So I'd like you just to do that really briefly as we kind of get started. Awesome. I can only see a couple of people, but it looks like you're writing, which is fab. Okay, so let's start by talking about mindset, because again, this is something that I talk about all the time. You'll hear me talking about creating a magic mindset. You'll hear me talking about like creating a mindset routine, having a mindset for success. But what do I actually mean when I'm saying mindset? So when I'm talking about mindset, I'm talking about your beliefs. I'm talking about clarity. I'm talking about your confidence. I'm talking about the self-talk, that little voice in your head that rattles on and on and on all day. Some of you will have a really fast little voice that talks lots and might need quietening down a little bit. Some of you might have a slower voice that only pops up every so often. But it's that self-talk. It's about how you show up, what you tell yourself, where you focus, and who you are every single day. Because ultimately, our mindset determines everything. Whether we believe we can or we believe we can't comes down to mindset. Whether we choose to take action or we feel stuck and feel like we can't move, that's all down to mindset. And what I've learned on my own journey is that when we are outside of our comfort zone, when we're doing something new, when we're trying something that might feel a bit scary because we just haven't done it before, our mindset can either really support us on that journey or it can really hold us back. And so it's really important to actually start looking at what's happening in your head that's either helping you or stopping you. And it's about realizing that it's not something that has to have control by itself. It's something that we absolutely have control of. And the thing is about mindset is it's not necessarily easy to get that control. I've just thought of an example in my head. I'm almost not sure if I should share it because it's going to make people cringe. But I was going to say it's a bit like a muscle in that I'll give you the okay version, then I'll give you the version that might make a few people cringe. I was going to say it's a bit like a muscle in that you've got to use it. You've got to build it. You've got to work on it daily to make it really strong. And the stronger you make it, the more it's going to support you on your journey. But in a way, when people first learn about mindset, not everyone even has the awareness that they can control their mindset. So the example that came to mind is for those of you who have children, your pelvic floor after you have a baby, and that moment where you suddenly realize that everything you took for granted because you'd been in your comfort zone with your pelvic floor. I've never used this example before, so bear with me as I go down the garden path. But you take it for granted until you try something new, which is trying to control your pelvic floor after you've had a baby, like trying to jump on a trampoline or trying to go and do a new gym class. And suddenly, oh my goodness, I've got this thing that actually needs work. And I think that's what happens with mindset when you start building your own business. It's almost like that sudden awareness of, oh my goodness, this needs work. And so I think it's worth really looking at mindset, unraveling it, seeing what it is, creating awareness around it so that you can start very mindfully putting into place the steps that you need to manage your own mindset so that you're the person in the driving seat rather than your mindset ruling the action that you take and the way that you feel on a daily basis. Is this making sense? Give me a little thumbs up or a little yes if you're on the same page as me. Awesome. Okay. I really like trainings where I can hear people and I can ask questions. I always feel a little bit like I'm talking to myself on these Zoom trainings. So as I check in with you, bear with me. So the other thing, before we even get into what those seven secrets are, the other thing that I think is really important around mindset is, for me, it's a real balance. Mindset is a balance of being and of doing, because I believe we need to do both to get the results that we want in life. When I say being, I'm talking about the way that you feel, the way that you show up, the person that you really are. When I'm talking about doing, I'm talking about the action that you're taking. Because mindset alone isn't enough. But equally, doing alone, action alone, isn't enough. It's got to be a really nice blend between the two. If you really want to get there without a constant battle, if maybe your journey so far has felt really difficult and it's felt like a battle for you and it's felt like you pushing, it's because there are probably things in your mindset that aren't in alignment. And that's why it's feeling like this never-ending fight. So you might have been taking the action, but you might not have been getting the results that you want, or maybe you have, but it's felt like really hard work. And if that's the case, then there's things in your mindset that we need to get into alignment and shift so that instead of pushing and pushing, you get pulled towards your goals and pulled towards your vision. And you get into that thing that we call flow, where it doesn't feel effortless, but it feels right. And you feel pulled along by it. And it feels almost more like a dance than a fight. That's the best way that I can describe it. So when I'm talking about mindset, it's always about the two things. They've got to go hand in hand. You've got to have the mindset and you've got to take the action. Otherwise, you just don't get the results at the end of the day. But if your mindset is in the right place, then the action is far easier to take and you can make sure you're taking the right action. And what I mean by the right action isn't the action that some strategy person or expert tells you to take. The right action is what fits with your values and your beliefs and your vision and who you are as a person. There, that's the right action. But quite often what can happen is when we are doing something new, we doubt ourselves and we instead put all of our trust into another person. And it's about coming back to self and trusting in who you are, what you're about and what you're creating. Okay, so let me share one more thing before we dive in to those seven secrets. And this is just a little bit about my personal journey, because you probably noticed that I am massively passionate about mindset. Mindset is my passion. Mindset is my thing. And there's a reason for that. It didn't just happen accidentally. I originally trained as a life coach about 9 years ago now when I was living in New Zealand. And I worked really hard because I was passionate about it. I wanted to do it. I wanted to help other people. I wanted to make a difference. I wanted to feel worthy because I was making a difference to other people. So that might give you a clue that there was perhaps something missing or not aligned in my own life back then. And I did lots and lots of courses and lots of training. I gave it 100% all the time. And in a way, I was very lucky because opportunities were presented to me in terms of working with some incredible people, working for some incredible organizations, which really helped me set up a strong coaching business over in New Zealand. When we then made the move back to the UK, I had a bit of a rude awakening and I lost my confidence. And I suddenly felt like this teeny, teeny, tiny little, not even fish, like little tadpole in this huge, big ocean. I felt totally lost. I felt totally overwhelmed. I didn't know how on earth I, little me, was going to start making an impact or even start a business in the UK. And so what I did, I got a bit lost. I got into overwhelm. I doubted myself and my skills. And so I switched and started thinking that the answer was outside of me. And instead of in the past where I'd been doing courses, I'd done them because I was enjoying them and I wanted to upskill. Instead, I went on this kind of frantic mission because I was desperate to find the answer. I was like, the answer must be out there. Somehow I'm missing the secret or the strategy or the one way or that one person who can just do it for me or just like magic the magic wand and make all of this just happen and fall into place. And I felt like I was really struggling and really pushing and really lost. And the more that I learned, the more webinars that I got on and the more courses that I signed up for, the more and more lost I got and less action I took. And it all shifted for me when I finally got my own coach and I realized that what I needed was not more knowledge. It was actually a coach to help me to start implementing all this knowledge that I already had. And instead of looking outside of myself, I started looking inside. And that was a really defining moment for me and for my business, because not only did it give me the clarity and the belief and the drive and the momentum that I needed to actually start doing this properly, it also gave me real clarity about what I was doing as a coach. Because until that point, I'd called myself a life coach, I'd called myself a business coach, I'd call myself an NLP coach, and none of it really fit properly. I felt like there was a piece of the puzzle missing. And it was only when I went through this in my own life that I had that real clarity and that moment of, oh my God, it's the mindset. It's actually specifically the mindset. And it's not just the knowing, it's the implementing. And it might sound so simple. It might sound like, well, of course, like everyone else gets that. But when you're stuck yourself, and I'm sure all of you can read, oops, picture's falling off the wall. when you're stuck yourself, and when you're in that moment of things just not working and you like trying really hard, but not really getting there, the obvious isn't always obvious to you. You get lost, right? And I'm sure that all of you can relate to that in some way, shape, or form, in some area of your life. So that was my moment of clarity when I realized it's actually about the mindset and it's not about gaining knowledge. It's about implementing the knowledge that we've already got. And it's not about common sense, because most of mindset comes down to common sense at the end of the day. But common sense, I think, who is it who says it? Richard Bouchard, he says, common sense isn't common practice. And that's so, so true. And I think that resonated really strongly with me. And I'm sure lots of you can think of areas of your own lives where you have the common sense, but that common sense isn't necessarily common practice. And you've got the knowledge, but you're not necessarily implementing it. And all of that comes back to mindset, and it comes back to self-belief, and it comes back to self-confidence, because you've got to step into that to be able to take action on it and implement it. Okay, after that little rant, who is ready to dive in and start hearing the seven secrets? I love it. I love that you give me the thumbs up. I absolutely love it. Like, that's where, like, the me that used to be a teacher comes in a little bit, that I like the little, like, hands up and the little thumbs up, just kind of go, yeah, we're all good. Right, let me get a sip of orange. And then let's start. Okay. Number one, secret number one. You might want to write this down, you might just want to listen. It's totally up to you. And I'm warning you, before we even jump in, you're going to go, I already know that. But I want you to take it further, and I want you to ask yourself, you might know it, but are you doing it? Are you living it? Are you showing up as if you know it? If a little alien was to buzz down from space and watch you, or do like some kind of magic body scan to see how much of this stuff you're implementing and really believing, like, what would its little, like, would you get a big tick, or would you get maybe a big, huge cross? So think about this as I'm going through it. So, secret number one. I'm just making you wait. Success starts with self. You've heard me say it before, but I think it is the biggest thing when it comes down to mindset, when it comes down to actually getting results. Success starts with self. If you've been searching for the answer, if you've been struggling, if you've been finding that you're playing round this circle in your head that just keeps going round and round, should I do this? Should I do that? I'll do that. I'll do that. I'll do that tomorrow. No, it hasn't done it. Oh my God, I'm rubbish. No, I'll do this time. And you're going round that cycle of trying to find an answer because you think that you're not quite enough yet, or you don't know enough yet, or you need just something else, then please, please, please just stop and take a look inside instead. Tony Robbins has a little saying of, if you're in your head, you're dead. And when I first heard that, I was like, what? What is he saying? But it's that whole, we get stuck in our heads, and we think that when we get stuck in our heads, we think that the answer lies outside of us, elsewhere. The truth is, you already know so much. You are already more than enough. With all the resources that you've already got, you can take those and you can implement those to start getting results right now in whatever areas of your life or your business that you want to. But you've got to stop the search. You've got to stop searching. You've got to stop searching outside of yourself. And you've got to stop thinking that there's this magic secret that somebody knows that they can just give to you and it will change the game. And the reason I feel so strongly about this one is because I spent so long thinking that by magic, someone would give me that little magic thing, that little magic pill, like almost believing that I don't need to make money because I'll magically win the lottery, even though I don't actually play the lottery, or something ridiculous like that, right? And it's going to play out. Everyone's going to have their own little version of that story, but I know that you probably know what I'm talking about. So stop searching outside of yourself and look inside of yourself. If you look inside, what are the things within you that actually need to change so that the results that you're getting start to change? What is it internally that needs to shift? What is it that you need to start believing about yourself? What is it that maybe deep down you're really craving, but you're not allowing that craving to actually, you're not letting it out? What is it that you're pushing down and pushing down and pushing down? And by doing that, you're stifling who you are and almost your personal power, instead of embracing it and claiming it and letting it free on the world. So if you were to do that and were to look inside yourself, and you can note this down, you can either just think it in your head or you can make a note about it. What are those shifts that would need to happen? What would you need to believe? What would you need to start noticing about yourself and your life and how you're showing up on a daily basis? I'm just going to give you like 1 minute. If anyone's got any questions, remember you can type them into the little box. What would be awesome, by the way, is if anyone wants to type their comments into the box. I know you might need to be a bit brave, but I know that you can all be super brave on here. And I know that I know lots of you. So if you feel like being brave, like type in your comments, because that would help people. I think it's always really reaffirming to know that you're not the only one. Like everyone has issues with mindset. And the thing is, they never go away. So no matter what level you get at, mindset is a journey, it's not a destination. Oh. I've got a picture on my wall that my little boy drew years ago. It's just fallen off, so that's what's scaring me. So mindset is a journey, not a destination. As we up level in our life, because life is a journey, and as we stretch ourselves and do new things, there are always going to be new mindset levels that we need to push past, new beliefs that we need to form, new things that we need to think, and more clarity that we need to go that next extra level. So I'd love it if you've got anything else to, if you want to share any of that. And part of that success, starting with self, comes down to that alignment, which you heard me mention before. And that alignment is about your values. So what you value about life, it's your beliefs, what you believe about yourself and about life. It's what you want to create. Those three levels are really key, because if you've got values that don't match up with what you believe about yourself and life, or beliefs that don't match up with what you're trying to create, that misalignment is going to create that battle. Okay, I'm going to jump on to secret number two. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through, I've got seven secrets to share with you, but I'm going to go through two of them more deeply. So we're going to do some work around two of them that we get to in a minute. Okay, so secret number two is, where focus goes, energy flows. Again, you've heard it before, right? But how often do you find yourself focusing on the thing that's wrong, or focusing on the thing that's missing, or focusing on what's not working? Every day, it's so easy to get sucked into noticing the negative and putting our focus there instead of focusing on what we're actually trying to create. So we get all caught up on, and we'll ask ourselves questions like, why is this not working? What do I need to change? Why is so-and-so being difficult about this? Why do I feel this way? If I think back to the questions that I used to ask myself maybe 10 years ago, I would say, I'd say horrible things to myself. So my focus was on awful things. I used to say, Claire, why are you so shit at this? Why can't you figure this out? Why can other people do it but not you? If your focus is there, what's that going to do to your self-belief in the results that you're getting? So I really want you to notice on where you're putting your focus. Is your focus currently going on where you don't want to go rather than where you do want to go? And if it is, first step is awareness. So first step is just noticing where your awareness is and catching it as often as you possibly can. The second step is very, very, I've forgotten the word, purposefully shifting your focus to the thing that you want to think about. There's two different levels you can think about this depending on what your beliefs are. If you believe in the law of attraction and things like that, then you'll have read that obviously what you focus on expands. So that thing that you think about, you put that energy out to the universe and it comes back to you. If you're not into the law of attraction, this still stands just as strongly, because there's a part of your brain called the reticular activating system. And it is set up because it knows that we get way too many signals and bits of information every single day. We can't possibly process all of it. So our reticular activating system focuses on those, where our focus is, that's the things it points out. So if you say, notice all the red things in the room right now, suddenly you notice all the bits of red, right, that might be around you. If I told you to then close your eyes, you can do this if you like. So have a look around you and just notice quickly all the red that's around you. Close your eyes. How many things that were blue did you see in the room when you had your eyes open? In your head, just don't open your eyes, don't cheat. how many bits of blue did you see? Did you notice any? There might be one or two people who did, but most people won't have noticed the blue. And they'll have to, I mean, because you're in your living room, you know your living room quite well, so it's not the perfect environment to do this. But if you were out in a different environment, it would be very, very hard for you to answer and say where those blue things were, because your reticular activating system was focusing on red, so it was noticing red. So if you're very focused on that goal or that result that you're trying to get, so let's say, for example, you're wanting to meet new like-minded people. Maybe that's something that you're trying to do more of this year. It's one of the things that I've set for myself this year, which is why it's come up. But if that's your focus, let's do the opposite first. If your focus is, I want to avoid people who bring me down and make me feel rubbish and who just aren't on the same page as me, if that's your focus, what do you think you're going to notice all the time? You're going to notice all those times when people are grumpy, not agreeing with you, not on the same page as you. Like, that's what you're going to notice, and that's going to pull your energy down and down and down. Whereas if you're focusing on, I wonder, like, who I'm going to meet today, who's really going to raise my energy, make me feel amazing, who I'm really going to connect with deeply, and potentially we could have an amazing relationship into the future, it's going to totally change how you go about your day. And it's the same in every single aspect. That's just one example, but it's the same in all aspects of your life and all aspects of your business. So please start being really aware of where you're focusing. Where focus goes, energy flows. Has anyone got any questions about that? Oh, I've got a couple of things written down. Let me read these out before I go any further. Oh, I've got quite a few. Hang on a minute. Right. Shazni, the thing that you need to believe that success is my birthright. What's just happened? You are viewing Elaine's iPad screen. Elaine, I'm viewing your iPad screen for some reason. Why has that happened? I don't want to switch to active speaker. Am I back? So are you. Okay. Can you see me again yet? No? Oh, what's happened? This is not so large active speaker. Nope. I've got Mandy now. What's happened? Aha, right. I'm back on Mandy. Hang on, Mandy. Pin video. Yes, I'm back. Sorry, don't quite know what happened there. That was a bit random, wasn't it? What was I doing? I was reading comments, I see. Shazni, to believe that success is my birthright. I absolutely love that, because that's so true, isn't it? Success is the birthright of every single one of us. I really think that's true, and I love that. I love this, so very true. To believe that I am brave enough and can make a difference to myself and others. I love that as well. To believe that I can and I will. I like that. I've got a picture on one of my walls that says I can and I will, because that's so true. That's it. Oh, there you go. There you go. I can and I will. Watch me. oops. Gosh, everything's falling down tonight. Laura. Ooh. Hey, would you phrase that with regards to money? Like, my friends always tell me to stop saying I'm skint, but I'm not sure what else to say when it's true. Okay, that's really cool. Yeah, so the thing that I would do, if we were looking specifically at money around that, if I was personally doing it, which I have had to do lots of times, I really try and focus on the money that I do have and what I'm doing with that. So, for example, times when I felt like money is a bit tight, one of the things I've done is I've made sure I've actually got money in my purse, even though there might not be very much money in the bank. Because when I've opened my purse, I've like felt good about the fact that I've got notes and I've got money in there, and it feels like, oh yeah, look, I've got all this money on me. Another thing that I do is I actually, the money that I bring in, whether it's work or otherwise, I track, so that I track the money that I bring into my life, because I want to, that's where I want my focus to be, on the money that I bring in rather than money that's going out. So all my outgoings, as often as possible, are all automated. They just happen because I don't really want to focus on those. I want to focus on the money that I'm bringing in. Or what I do actually, the money, when I'm spending money on me, something that feels good, so maybe it's a course or a program or something that I'm really excited to do, I'm very conscious of paying that money, because that actually feels like that's, I'm giving that money in a way, away for something far bigger that I'm getting back. Does that make sense? So I actually feel real gratitude towards that, giving the money away, because I know I'm going to receive far more. So So there's a few different things that you can play with, being very aware of the money as it does come in, and really kind of focusing on the gratitude towards that, setting the outgoings. Not because the thing is, if you're, I think you use the word skin, if you're skin, you thinking about that's not going to help you in any way. Whereas if you're focusing on bringing money in what you can do with the money you've got, feeling really gratitude for the money that you do have, that's automatically going to shift you and feel much better than if you're just worrying about the lack of money. So really think about what's coming in, the fact that you're really grateful for the money that you do have money in your purse. So it maybe feels like you've got more money than you've got. I hope that's useful. Let me know. Who was that? Laura. Let me know if that's useful, if there's anything else I can answer around that. Okay. So should we move on to number three? You ready to move on to secret number three? Yeah. Okay, awesome. Oh, I'm just skipping through people to have a look who's on here. It's awesome to actually see people writing down in here. Woo-hoo, it's lovely seeing people. That's fantastic. Okay, awesome. So, secret number three, and I was missing this one as well. So these secrets I put down are things that I've really, truly learned on my journey, and some of which I have to be very mindful still to do. But this was an important one for me. This was almost a breakthrough moment for me. Are you ready for it? Motivation creates momentum. What I mean by that is you need to create that momentum when you're building your business, or in fact, when you're doing everything, because it's the momentum that really takes you there. It's the momentum you need to not just take one or two steps and then stop. It's the momentum that you need to get started and really keep going and keep the excitement and keep the activity and keep the flow and like keep that vision and stay in your truth as you're on that journey. So momentum is super duper important. It's our motivation that creates that momentum. So there's a few different parts of this that I want to break down with you. The first part is that part of motivation is having a really strong why. I know in network marketing, for those people who are in network marketing on here, they talk a lot about having a strong why and knowing your why. What I've come across and what I've realized, and I did this as well, when I first was building my coaching business, and I heard this idea of I need to know my why, and I need to be clear on what my motivation is. I put my why as my children, and lots of people do that. If you've got children, the chances are you might have done that. But by doing that, without realizing it, I created this internal battle for myself, because on one hand, I was saying, I want to build my business for my children so that I can have more time with my children and more fun with my children and more love with my children. But because I'm building my business, I'm not with my children as much, because building a business takes time and it takes effort and it takes hard work. So I had this like battle going on constantly, and I was ping ponging between the two. And when I was working, I was feeling guilty because I wasn't with my children. When I was with my children, I was feeling guilty that I wasn't working. And one day I just had that realization. I was journaling. I had that realization that it's because the why that I've created for myself doesn't fit with what I'm doing. So I realized I needed to shift that why a little bit. And you can have your why connected with your children, but you have to be able to look at the longer, the bigger picture if you're going to do that. Because on a short-term basis, you're going to have to give your business time and effort if you're serious about growing it. So the way that I changed that, I decided personally that my why needed to be a selfish why. My why needed to be a why just for me, because while it was for my children, I was actually holding back because of that internal fight that I had going on. It was when I decided that I was going to be selfish with my why, and it's not actually selfish, but that was how I phrased it at one point. I decided that my why just needed to be all about me. The other thing that I hear people saying a lot with their why is I hear people saying, my why is because I want to help people. That might be true. The coaching that I do, I love. I can't tell you how grateful I am. The fact that I get to help people, I get to support people, I get to do what I love every single day, it means the world to me. but equally, I'm not a martyr. I have to make money doing this, and I get self-fulfillment from doing this. So it's not like I'm so incredible and amazing that I'm just all for helping other people. No, I get something from doing it as well. It fills me up. It gives me more self-worth. It makes me feel like my life's got a really strong purpose when I know that I can help other people. So if you take that even further, your why doesn't need to be a selfless why. I actually think your why should be selfish. What is your why for you? And for me, deep down, it was literally the fact that I knew I could be more. And I was like, I know I could be more. I know I could create more impact. I know I could help more people. I know that people could turn around and say, oh, like, this is a person you need to go to because she loves what she does. She gives it 100%. Once you're working with her, she will like go to the end of the world to help you because she is absolutely with you and involved. Like, and that's selfish in a way because that fills me up. So I want you to think about what's your why, what's your selfish why that's just about you, because I just wanted to know that I could be that person that I dream about. When you look at people like Tony Robbins, I'm about to come on to this, he talks about it was his why first started because he had a childhood that was really difficult and he felt like he had to win people's love. And so his why when he first went into all of the personal development stuff that he does is because he had his cup filled up. He felt loved when he stood in front of an audience and taught them and helped them and took them through that transformation that he takes people through. So again, his why, I don't think it is now, but to start with, his why was quite selfish in that he was getting something from it that he really needed. And I think it's okay to admit to yourself, what's the thing that you're getting from this that you really need? Because when you do that, I think it's that giving yourself permission to go, actually, this is here. This is a real reason. And this is why I've got to make it happen. So just be clear on that and write it down and use that. The second part of that motivation, you hear me talk about Tony Robbins a lot because I think the guy's incredible and I've done lots of his training. He talks about something called five fundamental human needs. And we each have these needs. We each have all of the needs, but we will have some of them that are stronger than others. Let me stop talking for a second and take a sip because I'm... because I'm rattling away too fast. So the five fundamental human needs that he talks about are certainty. I need for things to be the same. I need for us to know what's going to be happening. The second one is variety, the fact that we need change in our lives, otherwise we would be bored to tears. The third one is significance, so that feeling needed, feeling wanted, feeling like we have a purpose. The fourth one is loving connection, which I don't really need to describe. It says it itself. Actually, the six. I put five fundamental needs as six. The next one is growth, is in personal growth. He always says you're either growing or you're dying. There's no such thing as standing still. So the next one is growth. And then the final one is contribution. We all have those needs in different ways, and we fulfill those needs in different ways. He says, if you have something that you do that fulfills at least three of those needs, that thing actually can become an addiction. That doesn't mean a bad addiction, because some things could be really good addictions. So if in one area of your life, so for example, let's take someone who loves exercise. You can probably think of someone who loves exercise. They exercise loads. They get really fired up by exercise. They're always going down to the gym or doing classes or whatever. The chances are that exercise is meeting at least three of their needs. It might be the certainty, because they know what times they go. They know the gym they go to. They know that it makes them feel good. They know what happens when they work out. So it might be meeting the need for certainty. It might also be meeting the need for variety because maybe they do different classes or different workouts. It might be meeting their need for significance because they're making their body look good and they feel good about themselves because they're toned and they look fit and people go, wow, you're so good the way you go to the gym and you're so healthy. And so they might really get their significance fulfilled by that. They probably would also get that growth, that personal growth fulfilled because they're pushing themselves and constantly getting fitter and healthier and stronger. So that one thing, that person who's really tapped into their needs with that, going to the gym, fitness could have become an addiction. Let me tell you why I'm explaining this, because this comes down to your motivation. If you can tap what you're doing in your business or your life into those six fundamental needs, it's going to mean that you can show up far more fully and achieve your goals and end result far more easily because it's going to create that momentum. Does that make sense? I haven't explained it like this before, so I want to kind of just give me a little nod if you're getting that and it makes sense. If anyone's got a question about that, Mandy, this has just clicked for me, Claire, light bulb moment. Awesome. That's really good. So, how could you take what you're doing in your business right now and how could you link it to those fundamental human needs? How can building your business give you certainty? How can building your business give you variety? How can building your business give you significance? How can it give you love and connection? How can it give you personal growth? How can it let you contribute to the world or to the people around you? It hasn't got to the world. And it's worth, what I'd like you to actually do with this is I'd like you to think about this for a second and actually write that down. So how can your business or the business that you're wanting to start or that whatever area it is that you've got real goals in and that you really want to move forward in, how can you tap into those needs to really create momentum to help you move towards those goals or that vision or whatever you want to call it? Give you 2 seconds to do that. If you've got a question, pop it in, or if you want to write yours down, pop it in. That would be ace to have an example. Oh my gosh, time is flying by. The other thing, just to maybe ask yourself while you're doing this, or maybe after you get off the call today, is which are your core needs? Which are the ones that you really need fulfilling? Because we all have some that we need fulfilling in much bigger ways than others. So some people really like certainty. You know, there's people who like to have a routine. They like to know what's happening. They like, you know, they go to the same places on holiday each year because they like the fact that they know it and they know they're going to enjoy it when they get there and they maybe know the people and they know the nice places to go and eat and all those other things, where you'll have other people who will never go back on holiday to the same place. Every year it's got to be somewhere different. It's got to be a change. They love the fact that they're going to a new place and exploring somewhere new and meeting new people and going to new places. So that's just one example, right? In another way, that significance, that need to feel like what you're doing is worthwhile. I'm going to go back to Tony again, bear with me. but he gave the example, when I was at one of his trainings, he gave the example of significance can be met in different ways. So when you think about 9/11 that happened, those people who were on the plane and who hijacked the plane were in many ways potentially fulfilling their need for significance in doing that. So they were fulfilling that need in a really unresourceful way that was very painful for lots of people. On the other hand, those firefighters who ran into the building, not worrying about their own lives or the fact of how dangerous it was, they ran into the building to try and rescue other people. They might well have had a need for significance too, but they desperately wanted to help other people, and that's where their need for significance was coming from. So can you see that although it's significance, we can meet our needs in very different ways? Um, love and connection is quite an obvious one. Personal growth and contribution are quite obvious. So it might be worth like highlighting or ticking those that you feel are the needs that you really need fulfilling the strongest. And that can just be useful. Having that awareness can be useful in kind of looking at your life and how you're living your life and how it pans out in regards to those needs. Okay, how are we all doing? Let's jump on to the next one. Let me check, not any. Right, the next one is one of my favorites. In fact, it is maybe my favorite. And lots of you, I'm going to do a little exercise with you that lots of you might have done with me before, because it is one of my favorite little exercises. I love it. But equally, the more you do it, the stronger it gets, the better it is. So, secret number four. You ready? Give yourselves a bit of a shake out, because we've all been sat here for a while now. I feel like I need to put on some music and dance for a minute. Okay, so step number four is step into the identity of you who has already created the results. Step into the identity of the you who has already created the results. What I'm talking about here are the traits that you will have having been on that journey to getting the results. The person you will have had to have become on that journey. And when I say that, I'm not talking about some other person. I'm talking about like the best version of you, obviously. But that person that you've had to become to be able to get those results. What are those traits? So quite often, like if you think about that big goal or that big vision that you might have, maybe it's a year from now, maybe it's a few years from now, maybe you've got that picture in your head of the life that you want to be creating. But you might find yourself thinking, I'll feel like this, or I'll be this person when I've achieved it. The truth is, it doesn't work like that. If you want to really embrace that goal, if you really want to create that vision, if you want this to happen, you have to start showing up today with those traits, with those values of the person who's already got there. So let me give you an example for this. I'm going to give the example of speaking on stage. Okay. So maybe you've got this vision of you want to stand on stage and speak and help other people by sharing your message. And this vision is in the future. So you're thinking it's a year from now, maybe it's even longer. And you think, when I stand on that stage, I will feel so confident and I'll believe in myself and I'll know what I'm saying and I'll be the total expert and I'll be doing this every day and I'll be driven and I'll be like super fit and super healthy and I'll look amazing and I'll have had a stylist and I'll have done this and I'll have done that. And you might well have this whole big list of all this person that you are when you stand on that stage. The thing is, unless you become that person now, you're probably never going to actually stand on that stage. You've got to start showing up right now as a person who is brave and has their message and shares it and makes a difference and is confident and believes in themselves and all of those things that I just mentioned. You've got to start doing that now today. You've got to start showing up like that every single day and being the best version of you every single day in order to actually make that happen. Now, that doesn't mean that it's got to be a struggle. That actually means that it's far easier than it might have been so far. Because if you're believing there's a part of you who's already achieved that, then you've got all the answers. You know how you got there. So that question of how, you can just take out and throw away, because you'll be able to figure that out easily if you're imagining it from a viewpoint of already having achieved it. Let me give you an example. If I'm stood on this stage right now, what were the steps that I took to getting here? And it's a lot easier. You'll feel a lot more resourceful asking yourself that question than saying, oh my goodness, how do I ever go from here to standing on that stage. It's a lot easier to imagine that you're there and look backwards rather than stand here and imagine looking forwards. Does that make sense? It can take a little bit of, like when I first heard this idea, and I don't even remember where I first heard it, but it took me a while to wrap my head around it. But once I did, it was super powerful, really, really powerful. And it was once I did that I actually stopped and asked myself, if I was being really honest with myself right now, and I was looking at my life objectively and how I'm showing up on a daily basis objectively, and I was going to give myself a score, 1 to 10. 10 would be me being the absolute best version of me, the me when I'm on fire and I have self-belief and I have confidence and I'm motivated and I'm doing it and I'm out there going, woohoo, like I've just, and got, not just woohoo, no, but also got that like deep core feeling of groundedness and yes, this is right. Like that would be the 10. One would be when you have a terrible day and you just hide in bed. If you ask yourself now, where are you on a daily basis? What number would you give yourself on that score, 1 to 10? I think most people, if you're brave, put in what number you'd give yourself. Because I think most people, if you're being honest, probably fall in the like, 4 to 6 or 7 category. You can give me a nod if you'd agree with that. So most people know that really, if you were being honest, you've got way more you can give. You can be far more of you. You could show up far more fully because you know you've got it inside you, right? So why? Like, why do we do that? Why do we stick to being a 4, a 5, a 6 when you could be a 9 or a 10 every single day? Why? So what I want you to start thinking about, because you've now got that awareness, is actually if you were up in that number, if instead of showing up as a 5 or a 6 or whatever, instead you were showing up even just one mark higher, even if you just took it one mark higher. So if you're a 7, make it an 8. If you're an 8, make it a 9. How would that change your life? How would that change how quickly you're getting the results that you want to? And how would you show up differently every single day? What would you tell yourself that's different? What would you believe that's different? What action would you take that's different based on that? Because I think this is really important. And I think here's why I think the problem is. I think generally society is happy being mediocre. Most people are happy being average and just bobbing along, not realizing, I think, what an amazing gift life really is. I think we always just, we take it for granted because we're living it every single day. But I think if we all stop taking it for granted, sorry, I'm trying to get comfy on my seat. If we all stop taking it for granted and we really started living every single day fully, really being in the moment, really showing up as our best self, really not holding back, I think that the life that we could all be living could be so much different. We could have so much more impact. We could feel so much happier. We could feel so much more fulfilled on a daily basis. We could create so much more with the time that we've got on this planet. So that's just, I don't want to get all ranty at you, but I think it's food for thought, because I think that most people are showing up in that number, and if you just make it one higher, that could make a huge difference because of that compounding effect. Okay, now I want to do a little, you can call it a visualization or a little bit of hypnosis or whatever you want to do. So what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to put down pens and paper, get a bit comfortable. You need to be able to hear me still. You might have done this with me loads of times because I love it, but that's okay. And I'm just wondering, I might put a bit of music on in the background as I do this. That's not what I want. Where am I? Oh, remind me later. Let me pop on a little bit of music because I feel like we need to get in the vibe a little bit. We'll go for that one. Can you hear that? Just quietly. Awesome. Okay. So I'd like you to stretch you on to the sky because you've all been sitting still. Do a bit of a stretch. Take a deep breath in. Blow it out. Give yourself a little bit of a shimmy, shimmy, shake. Okay, and I'd like you to take another deep breath in. I'd like you to blow it out quite forcefully. One more time. And then I'd like you to listen to me, but I'd like you to close your eyes. I'm going to keep my eyes open as I talk you through it. Actually, that's probably not the best piece of music. Let me stop that. Okay, so with your eyes gently closed, I'd like you to just be aware of your breath and breathing deeply in and out gently. And I'd like you to just loosen your shoulders and lose any tension that you can feel in your body at the moment. And I'd like you to imagine a little golden ball coming down and resting on the very top of your head. A beautiful glowing golden ball. And that golden ball is slowly going to be absorbed into you. And as you absorb it slowly into your body, and it goes all down the back of your head, around your forehead, over your face, feel all of your muscles just relaxing. Feel a warmth and a calmness starting to wash over your whole body. And take that beautiful golden glow all the way through your jaw, down the back of your neck, through your shoulders. Let it wash down your arms to the tips of your fingers. Let it wash down your spine, through your hips, into your legs, your knees, all the way down through your feet into the very tips of your toes. And as you feel that relaxation washing over you, take another deep breath in. And let it out slowly. And just really let yourself relax. And I'd like you to start seeing a picture in your mind's eye. And that picture is about a year from now. And in that picture, you can see yourself a year from now. And I'd like you just to start noticing, firstly, how you look. How does the version of you a year from now look? What else do you notice about yourself? How are you dressed? How are you standing? I'd like you to notice where you are. Maybe you're on a beach. Maybe you're in a foreign country. Maybe you're in a house. Maybe you're alone. I don't know. I just want you to notice your surroundings though. And I want you to really notice that future version of you. Because that future version of you made the decision to be the very best version of herself every single day. That future version of you committed to her dreams and her vision and her goals and her desires and her wants and her needs. That future version of you embraced all of it. And by doing that, that future version of you has grown beyond belief. That future version of you is so confident. That future version of you truly believes in herself. That future version of you is living the life every single day that once was only a dream. And as you notice that confidence and that glow and that energy that that future version of you really has, I want you just to notice how far you've gone and what you've created and who you've become. And I want you to notice how that future version of you is standing. Because even in the way that that future version of you is standing, you can see the confidence and the calmness and the surety just rolling off you. And as you look at that future version of you who feels amazing, I want you to notice what her thoughts are. What does she say to herself on a daily basis? What does she believe about life? What does she believe about herself? After having the best year she could ever have dreamt of, what does she now believe is possible in her future? Because after creating this year, wow, the possibilities that lie ahead are incredible. How does she feel on a daily basis? And I want you just to notice that. And as you look at that future version of you, I want you to notice how good it would be to feel that way. How much you'd like to step into that right now. That version of yourself that is just so amazing and glowing and beautiful from the inside out. That version of you who truly owns who she is and what she's about and what she stands for and what she believes in, and who inspires other people with that belief every single day. And in a moment, when you're ready, I'm going to count down from 3 to 1, and you're going to actually step into that future version of you. So as you look at this future version of you right now, and you notice that energy and that glow and those beliefs that she has, I want you to notice how good it would feel to actually step into that version of yourself and to experience that right now for yourself. How powerful that would feel. How that would change what you believe about yourself right now. And so on the count of 3, when you're ready, you're going to step in to that version of yourself, that best version of you. And as you do so, you're going to take a deep breath in. So what I'd like you to do now, if you're ready, you give me a little nod as you look at that future version of you. Fantastic. And on the count of 3, 1, 2, 3, step into that future version of you and take a deep breath in and really connect together. Merge and become one person. And as you do that, feel the power that flows through you. Feel the sense of calmness that flows through you, the sense of fulfillment, the sense of gratitude, the sense of love, that real fulfillment that goes so deep to your core that this is who you really are. This is what you can really create. This is you. This is what you're capable of. And notice those new beliefs that you have now, that you've created all of this. Notice the confidence that you feel. Notice what you say to yourself and what you believe about yourself, and notice how good it feels. And I want you to take that feeling now as this future version of you, and I want you to take it and wash it throughout your body. I want you to give it a color, and take that color and take it up from the top of your head all the way down to the tip of your toes. And as it flows through your body, you can even make that feeling more powerful if you want to. And you can wash it over yourself and enjoy it and relax in it and bathe in it, knowing that this is who you truly are. This is you at your core. This is the you that's been waiting to get out for all of those years. And know that this is your chance to give yourself permission to really show up as the true you, as the best version of you, as the person who can create that vision, who can live those dreams, who can absolutely smash those goals. And I want you to take that feeling and that color, and I want you to take it into a beautiful little shining ball that shines and glows so brightly. And I want you to take that ball in both of your hands now. And when you're ready, I want you to put that ball against your heart and let it absorb into your heart. So that feeling, and that belief and that confidence is always with you from now on. It's there whenever you need it. You just need to look inside yourself, because that's where your success lies. That's where your future lies. You are already so much more than enough. You already know far more than enough. You just need to start being that best version of you and believing in yourself today. And it's just a decision. And you can do it anytime you choose. And when you're ready, I want you to take a deep breath in and let it out slowly. I'd like you to open your eyes when you're ready. How did that feel, everybody? Give me a thumbs up if it felt good. I'm going to flick through everyone to just check on how everyone's feeling. Is everyone feeling okay? Okay, awesome. Okay, what did you notice about that exercise? What did you notice about the future you? What can you take away from that right now and start implementing today? And it might be a belief, it might be a feeling, it might be an action. It might be different for every single one of you. So Jida, what have you put? So powerful and relaxing, awesome. Claire, feeling great, fantastic. Leslie, she's thinner. That's hilarious. Awesome. Who is awesome? I think awesome's Mamie and Maria. Feeling fab, that's really cool. Hold on, there's one more up there that I missed. Let me just see what that comment was. Sorry, Claire. It's really good, but my head isn't in it right now. Business distractions. Can you confirm that you're uploading the recording? Yes, absolutely, Laura. The recording will be there, so you can do it when you're in a better space to kind of do it. Mandy, incredibly powerful. Loved it. Awesome. Love that you all enjoyed that. Laura Bullis, amazing. Thank you. All right, fab. Okay, so that's my biggest one. I love it. And I think it's so, so important. So I'd just love you to take, I don't want to talk about that anymore, that particular point, but I want you to take that, know that you can tap back into that energy and back into that belief whenever you want it. Okay. One of the things, actually, before I move on, is I'd like you to think about what the traits were of that future version of you that you can start living into right now. It might have been a sense of calmness. It might have been a sense of motivation. It might have been believing in yourself. It might have been taking more action. Whatever it was, just make a little note of it so that you can remind yourself of that. And another thing that you could do, which can be really powerful, is from that little visualization or whatever you want to call it, take that feeling that you had and turn it into an affirmation that you can use every day. That's going to help you create that vision, that's going to help you make that come to life. Okay, are you ready for the next point, the next secret? Let me see where I'm at. Okay, I mentioned at the beginning that some of these things I do really easily now. Some of these things I have to be very conscious of doing. And I have to really work that muscle. And this next one is one of those things that I have to be really aware of, be very conscious of, and do it on purpose. So this next secret, number 6, is choose to be totally, unapologetically you. Choose to be totally, unapologetically you. What I mean by that is we can get swayed from our vision, from our dreams, from our goals, by the people around us. It can be really hard sometimes if we have a different version of what life should be about to the people around us. Not only that, but we can apologize as well. And I think women do this all the time, far too much. We almost apologize just for being us. We apologize for, oh, I'm so sorry that I did that. Oh, I'm so sorry that I thought that. Oh, I'm so sorry that I dared speak my mind. Oh, I'm so sorry. Like we apologize for the person that we are so often. And I fall into this trap as well. So I have to be very mindful of it, of actually owning this is me, this is what I believe, this is what I stand for. And no, you might not agree, you might have different beliefs, and that's totally fine. I don't mind whatever beliefs you've got, equally accept mine. So it's just that, actually just choosing to be you. So instead of feeling like when you're in certain situations, this is a good one to ask yourself, when you're with certain people or in certain situations, do you find yourself almost trying to do that whole people pleasing thing where you're trying to keep people happy, and because of that you're not fully yourself, you kind of become maybe a lukewarm version of yourself, or you might say things that you don't always believe, or you might agree just for the sake of agreeing, and then afterwards it roils you and you think, oh, why did I say that? Why did I do that? Why did I let myself get pulled along? Why didn't I stand up and say, actually, you know, I hear that, but for me it's different. So where in your life could you be more unapologetic about who you are and own who you are more fully and what you stand for more fully and your beliefs more fully, and the action that you take more fully? And how could that change things? There's a part of this, it fits in quite nicely with this, that I call having courageous conversations. And I now very purposefully have courageous conversations with friends and family members, where once upon a time I would have kept my mouth shut because I didn't want to upset people. Or I didn't want people to think badly of me, or I maybe didn't want people to think I might be stupid, or like whatever it might have been. And so I wouldn't say the things that I wanted to say. If I catch that happening now, I now purposefully have a courageous conversation, which basically means coming from love, but speaking the truth as I feel it. So it's not saying you do this to me or you make me feel this way. It's saying, hey, when this happens, I find myself feeling this way, or I take it to mean this, or it makes me start questioning myself, or do you know what I mean? It's coming from a place of like, when this happens, this is how I feel. You might not mean it like that. I might be taking it wrongly, but can we talk? Can we actually talk about this? And it's interesting because I've been doing this very, very purposefully for the past year, a lot of my close relationships have shifted. Some have got so much deeper and are absolutely amazing relationships now. A few have drifted away because people just weren't on the same page and they were just like, I can't do this. But where could you have maybe those courageous conversations in your own life? Or where could you be more unapologetic about who you are, what you stand for, what you're doing? Okay, so I'm conscious of time, so we've been going ages. So I'm going to shift on to number 7, which is give yourself permission. Give yourself permission. I think this comes about because as kids, we wait to be given permission. We wait to be told, yes, you can go and do that. Yes, it's all right to do that. Like, yes, that's the right decision. And so even as adults, I think we don't let go of it fully. We still kind of hold on to it. And we want someone to say to us, it's okay, go and do that. And one of the things that happens all the time in my coaching, are people almost are waiting for me to give them permission and say, that's okay, you can do that. And of course, I can do that. But really, you want to be able to give yourself that permission. So choose, if you haven't been doing something that you really want to do, if you've been putting something off that you really want to do, if you've been questioning whether you should or shouldn't do something, but really you know you should, you're just a bit scared, just choose to give yourself permission. I need to stop overthinking and start doing. I love that. Did I miss number 5? I don't know, maybe I missed number 5. Number 5, the step into the identity of you who's already created the results. I'm also curious about 35. Oh, 5. So number 5 is the one that we did the visualization on, step into the identity of you who's already created the results, if I didn't make that clear. And the last little bit, because I said it was 7 secrets, but I've written down 8, which might mean I just got my numbers wrong. But the last one is just be committed to doing the work, because yes, there is a lot of mindset work that you can do to really shift your beliefs and make taking the action easier. That is a huge part of the puzzle. But equally, nobody can do the work for you. At the end of the day, you've got to show up and you've got to do the work yourself. You've got to take the action yourself, and it will feel scary and it will feel outside your comfort zone. But the more you do it, the more it will build your self-belief and the more it will build your self-confidence. And so that every step of the way, it's almost like you catching up with yourself every step of the way. You push yourself, you grow, you push yourself, you grow, you push yourself, you grow. And it's a never-ending journey, but it's also, I believe, a really exciting journey. Now, what I would really like to share with you is at the moment, I'm running a group program called You Revolution, which is very much based on what we've been sharing today. If you've enjoyed listening to this training, and I know it's been quite a long one, it's been like an hour and 20 minutes, so I really appreciate that you've all been on here. I think it's absolutely incredible that you've been here, you've listened, you've played for life, you've taken part, you've taken notes. It's incredible, and I love you to pieces for it. If you know that you've got a vision, you've got dreams, you've got goals, you need to get to that next level, but you know that you need to start here because maybe there's some self-belief, some confidence, some blocks going on. Maybe there's, you need to start giving yourself permission a bit more and you need someone to help you through that process, because most of the time we can't see our own blind spots. We need someone else to see our blind spots. If that sounds like you, I would love to just tell you briefly about You Revolution. I'm currently running one program of it, which has got 8 incredible women on it who are all amazing. And it is like, you could speak to those, but I'm getting fantastic feedback and it feels really, really good. I'm going to start my second run of You Revolution at the end of January. Bear with me a second. Because it's only the second run, so people who joined the first one got a discount. People who are on the second one are also going to get a discount. It's going to be half price what it's going to be. So if you're thinking that you would like some help, but maybe you're not in the place where you want one-to-one coaching, but you want support from a group, you want training each week, you want to be able to get on a call and actually have some one-to-one time with me so that you get to talk about how you're implementing that learning and any specific blocks and things that come up for you. You Revolution is an 8-week program. It runs for 8 weeks. Every week you get a training and we do a group call. And on that group call, I go through every single person to check that you're not just getting stuck or standing still. One of the things that I don't like about like online programs is that you're just left to yourself. Like, you get this program, but if you get stuck, there's no one there to help you. And quite often, because you don't have the accountability, you get left behind. And before you know it, you've forgotten all about the course and you never completed it. What I wanted to do and what I felt really passionate about doing was having an option for people to work with me so that they still got the results, but in a slightly different format, but you weren't just left alone to do it by yourself. So the idea of You Revolution is that I'm here every step of the journey with you to support you, to hold you accountable, to help you through any blocks, to help you with the blind spots, so that you can start creating the results that you want. And it doesn't matter whether it's for business, whether it's for health, whether it's relationships, maybe it's a combination of all of it. The results that you're getting come back to mindset. So it's all about the mindset. It's all about starting with you. And in the last few weeks of it, we look about what your purpose is, what your message is, and in terms of your business, how you get visible and how you do it in a way that's authentic for you and feels really good for you. So I just want to briefly mention this. It's not going to be some big sell or anything like that, because I don't believe in pushing things. I don't believe in putting pressure on people, but I want you to know that it's available because I am super duper excited about it. And I really believe in this program. I think it's incredible. So at the moment, we start the last week of January. I've got 2 awesome women who are already in there. So I've only got 6 places left. The full price when this is going to be running is going to be $995. So this run is $499. So for people who want to get on in the second run of You Revolution, it's £499. And as a little thank you for fast action takers, the first three people who hop on and say, yes, I'm in, I'm going to give you an extra coaching session, an hour's one-to-one coaching session. And that's actually worth over £200 in itself. So that's, so you get an extra add-on bonus. Okay. If you've got questions about this, I'm more than happy to answer any questions. What I'm going to do in Dreamcatchers is I'm going to put a scheduling link in there in the newsfeed, so that if you want to book in to have a chat with me, to ask any questions or to see if it's for you, then you can do that. Because I know that you might be going, I don't know, is it for me? Is it what I want to be doing? Will I get the results that I want from doing this? Who's going to be in the group? How does it work? Blah, blah, blah. So if you've got questions around it that you want answering, you can either message me, and I'm happy to talk, or book in for a You Revolution 30-minute chat, just so that you can get those questions answered. The two women who are already having that group are incredible. I'm super excited to start working with them. I think this is a game changer. I believe in it fully. I've given it a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of love. And so I feel compelled to share it, and I feel passionate about sharing it. So I just wanted to put that out there, that if you would like to do more work, if you've been thinking about getting a coach, or knowing that you'd like someone to support you on that journey, then I would love to be the person to do that. I'm here if you've got questions. But regardless of that, I want to say firstly, thank you for being part of Dreamcatchers, because that's incredible. And I love how you show up. I love how you interact. I love how you take part, because it means the world to me. And secondly, thank you for being here on this call tonight. I hope it's been helpful. I hope it's been useful. My hope when I get on and I do a call like this, or I do a live stream, or I speak on stage, or whatever it might be, my thing from it is that if I've helped one person with one thing, then I'm happy. So I hope that you found it useful. I hope that you've got value from it, because I know that you've given your time, and time is very valuable. If you've got any questions, I'll read through any now. If anyone's got like big questions, then stay on, put your hand up, and I can come and actually have a quick chat with you now. So let me just check what's going on in the comments. Leslie, I have terrible self-belief. Okay, Leslie. Linda, thank you so much, Claire. Very grateful. Thank you, Linda. Shazni is in You Revolution. You Revolution is incredible. You owe it to yourself. Thank you, Shazni. Awesome. Mandy, Claire, thank you. You're incredible. I could listen to you all evening long. Oh, thank you, Mandy. That is absolutely lovely. Thank you so much, Claire. It was worth it in the cold car. Bless you. Thank you so much. Sajida, You Revolution is on another level. Yes, Sajida is also in You Revolution. Incredible woman. Thank you, Claire, for being an inspiration. Thank you so much. Rebecca, thank you. You're brilliant. Thank you, Rebecca. Can't wait to get started with you. Thank you. Awesome. Amazing. Thank you, Margaret. Elaine, thank you, Elaine. Claire, thank you. What's that? I'd like to know more, I guess, that book cart tonight. Laura, message me and let's book you in for a quick chat if you're still on the line. Victoria, amazing. Thank you. Alison, thank you. Okay, awesome. So I don't think anybody's got any questions. What I would like you to do, I'm going to put it on a different screen so I can just see everybody. Feel free to say goodbye and hop off now. If there's anyone who's got any questions, then stay on. I think there's a thing where you can like put your hand up or something. So feel free to do that. What I'm going to do, if you could unmute yourself, anyone who's got questions, unmute yourself now and just someone start talking to me. If you can't unmute yourself, someone tell me that and I'll do it for you. Oh, gosh. Is it Maria who's awesome? I'm not sure, but it's 5:75 a.m. and you're happy to go to bed. Oh, my gosh. Like, mwah, that is commitment. Thank you so much. It is Maria. Thank you. That is absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for being here, Maria. That is, like, honestly, mwah. Victoria, thank you. Okay, so can you unmute yourselves? Give me a head or a no, you can't. Right, let me see if I can unmute you then. Sorry, I'm not super clever with this. I need to figure out how to looks like right, so it looks like I can unmute you one at a time. So Linda, let me unmute you, Linda. Unmute. Hi.
Hello. I'm just playing around because it's the first time I've been on here, so I'm doing everything, whatever I can. But thank you very much for your time. It was brilliant. Thank
That's
you.
Awesome. Thank you, Linda. I'm glad you found it useful. That's fab. Okay, I will mute you back up again then. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Does anyone else put your hand up for me if you want to speak? Anybody? Who have we got? Margaret, do you want to say anything? Laura? Angie? Still quite a few people on. Has anyone got any questions or anything you'd like to say? No? Well, okay, in that case, good night. Thank you for being here. Go be amazing. Get in touch if you've got questions about your revolution. Mwah. Okay, take care, everybody. Thank you for showing up. I'll stay on here just in case there's anyone left who wants to ask questions, but otherwise you're free to go. Okay, awesome. Bye-bye. I'm going to hang up. Linda, I'm assuming you're not quite sure how to hang up. Okay, bye.